Let's first talk about the technology. How does this work?
Sure. So we basically leverage the phones that we have on us all the time and unlock their ability to communicate on a peer-to-peer basis with these devices that enable peer-to-peer communication. So we essentially are taking this mobile infrastructure that's around us all the time already and unlocking their ability to function without the use of centralized connectivity, be that Wi-Fi, satellite, or the internet.
Now, we've all had this problem, but you started out focusing on consumers and then pivoted to focusing on the military and first responders. Obviously, hugely important that they stay connected. How big of a market is that for you?
Yeah, that's a great question. So it's a $26 billion a year opportunity, which should come as a little surprise given how important it is for people who put their lives on the line for others to have a lifeline both to each other and back to central command. And we're really proud that our technology is being used to allow these people to command and control their missions more efficiently and get home safely.
So how much money are you making and can you make off
sure.
of this technology?
So, you know, our average contract within the public sector is a multi-million dollar contract, and 70% of our customers also subscribe to software on top of that. We think the opportunity is really big. We are really innovating in a space where, you know, these customers are used to paying a ton of money for technology that's not upgradable, and we're turning that on its head. And instead, you know, we see the opportunity to have a volume business where every single soldier in the battlefield, every single wildland firefighter out west, you know, is enabling communication between their peers so they can do their job more safely. And so we have innovated not just in creating these incredible mesh networks, but also on the price. And so the average unit that we sell is about $800. But, you know, if you're selling multi-million dollar contracts, you can tell that's quite a lot of units.
Now, it's no secret that women are underrepresented in tech, underrepresented in entrepreneurship, and founders like yourself run into many challenges when trying to raise money in a male-dominated venture capital community. But what is lesser known is that women who start companies that are not focused on women things, like, let's say, fashion or e-commerce or beauty, have it even tougher. How have you overcome the challenges of raising money in a Silicon Valley community when you're focused on the military, when you're focused on a more sort of gender neutral pursuit, let's say?
Yeah, I think that our technology is exceptional. Again, it, you know, helps people in the most high stakes situations, in life or death situations. And I think that the reason we've been able to succeed in spite of these additive biases in Silicon Valley is precisely because the technology is so game-changing. And it has also not just applications in the public sector, but if you believe in a future where billions of things need to be connected to one another at all times, you're going to need a network topology that's mobile and low power, low cost, that's going to actually make that happen. And we believe that GoTenna will be that underlying communication stack for myriad applications, including emerging markets and mass market use cases.